system.
Just put it, flush it out, Lord. What is wrong with you?
She was so upset, and like, I just want her to be able to smell herself. And then it's like, herself. Why your
feelings hurt? I'm just trying to help you.
Yeah. So there was a girl that I taught 2 years in a row, not because she failed, just because I moved in the subject. And so our first year, I chopped it up to freshman ignorance. And then the next time I taught her, it wasn't 2 years in a row, I'm sorry, it was her junior year. Then I finally had the one-on-one conversation with her, like, listen, there's some must going on. And she was like, I told my mom to take me to the doctor. Bless her heart.
Did they go?
I don't remember the follow-up on it. It was a couple years ago. Because I
wanted to know what the diagnosis was
about her sweat. She used to
pH. It's the pH balance or imbalance.
Mm-hmm. And I told her, you know, stop eating those Flaming Hot Cheetos. First of all, stop eating pickles.
Yes.
Stop eating all those acidic foods because it is a pH. You're right. The acidic balance in your body is all thrown off. All you drink is soda. You hadn't drank not one sip of water. I've never seen you with anything fresh. You're probably pickled on the inside, and that's why you smell like that.
What was it that
you smell? Onions. Funyuns. All that. But like... I really hope that she was able to get that together. Because you're a junior in high school at this point. You know? And I think the first time, I think she told me she was coming from PE. So I was like, okay, well, she's working hard, you know, working out. I get it. The next time was when I actually had to have the heart-to-heart with her. The next 2 years, after 2 years after that. Because I was like, listen.
It should have been
you told me this was a PE must. But even like me and World Famous were trying to talk to Missy about it, and we were like, we played sports. We weren't musty after we were done playing.
Nope.
So why are you thinking that because you're playing volleyball that you should be musty? Like, that's not.
And what is it? Does your daughter go into the? My child goes into the. It's okay. I don't care. Like, she's in the real, and I'm like, what you mean?
I'll just be musty.
Yes. What do you mean? You don't.
I mean, but I kind of am like, oh, that's good. You don't care, but
I think that's a double-edged sword. And I'm just like, are you saying that just because you feel like you don't need to receive it because you don't want people to pick at you? Mm-hmm. Like, that's still not good because at the end of the day, you not caring about you being messy ain't gonna keep people from talking about you.
I know. And I was mortified. I went into last night, went to volleyball practice, walked past her because I dropped her off. She ran in and I parked, sat in the car, did some stuff, then came in. So I walked by her and I could smell the must. And I was like, wanted to say, put your arms down in practice. Like, the other teammates,
keep it way low.
They're going to hear you. They're going to smell you. Like, your teammate. Like, I just felt like.
They will. Really, and they're not going to want to guard her. Well, sorry, I'm thinking basketball. Sorry, I'm having flashbacks.
Yeah. I mean, if it's basketball, you can be musty because then no one want to guard you. Then you get all the shots.
That ain't it. I'm talking about in practice when you got to run those scrimmages and you got the musty girls. You got the
I had a musty girl on my volleyball team. And the girls called her the musty girl.
Aww.
Like, if she missed practice, they didn't even use her name. They were like, that musty girl.
Oh, see, you don't want to be known as the musty girl. Mm-hmm. Lord, this is, my husband said it was this girl when he was in school. And there's this tree that kind of smells musty.
Yeah, the pear one. It's a.
I don't know what. You know which one I'm talking about, though?
I know which one. It's like a fishy musty.
Yeah. And there,
it's a pear type tree.
Oh, I should have known you would know. Yeah. Yes.
So, we have one on our school campus.
I'm so excited that you know. So, your twin also had one on his school campus in high school. And they used to call it the Emily tree. Because the girl named Emily was musty.
But that smells worse than must. It's like...
Well, they called it the Emily tree because it smelled like her. And I'm like... And then... doctor goes... Y'all want nobody to come run around talking about this Ansel tree.
Oh, shoot.
To my daughter.
So, like, what is the best way to address it? Because clearly,
trash or candy. Which one do you choose?
Which one do you? But
Missy, I feel like I need to write a book about it.
Missy is quick to. Have you heard the one about the pigeon? It's like a series of this pigeon that has poor hygiene. I need to get those and show it to her.
Yeah, get them for your niece.
Yes, we all will read through those.
Because you know it's another book we all got to get to, The American Girl.
What we need to do is...
have a session.
Assign... I'm big on this. Have you? Who is your person? Your person. Like, for you, like, if my breath smelled bad, I would expect for you to tell me that. You know what I mean? Like, if I had a booger... you're my person. I expect for you to tell me that.
Yes.
Like, at school, if I have red lipstick on my teeth, I know Alicia better say something. Because I'm like, you are my person. And you let me run around looking, like, sounding, smelling. Like, all of that. You need to have a person. So, Ansley can be Missy's person. If they're ever together, they need to be able to check themselves. Because I can't
be like, yay, we messy together.
Ooh, my breath stinks. Does yours? Yes.
High five. Like, you friends forever. We the musty girls. That's my fear. It's my fear that they turn into that.
I don't think they want to be musty. I don't think they want to be
musty. But they don't care. When do they start caring? My husband said when they start liking boys and little boy hurt their feelings and be like, oh, musty girl. And then they start taking bath. I say, shut your mouth.
Does it have to get to that?
Right.
I mean.
Because by that time, it could be hurt. Their reputations could be ruined.
Well, I think after yesterday, because me, world famous, then me, then world. We tag team her all night long about Musk. And she was crying. She's so sensitive. Crying. Defending herself. I was like, listen. We're just trying. So this morning, she woke up, took a bath. Put more deodorant on. Like, so I feel like she may have gotten it after that. I hope. Let's cross our fingers. Mm-hmm. Because her brother still hasn't. So I think that her getting it before he does will be her goal. That's been her goal for her whole life.
Yes.
She was potty trained before him. She was. She's been able to hold her plate and walk from the kitchen to the table, like, early. Like, she just, so I'm like, I don't expect for you to be musty like him. I expect for you to go past. We're not setting.
Yeah, maybe you can say, do you smell like your brother? Do you realize some days you smell like your brother?
She'd probably be mortified with that. Like, because she's always
y'all
like,
used to write.
He stunk up my whole room with his smell. So, in a nutshell, you know, ladies, your vibe tribe should be able to tell you about yourself. Also, talk to your kids about personal hygiene and diet, because if not anything else, like, if they're musty still after all the things that you've done with washing and deodorant and lotion and all that, then maybe you need to go ahead and, like, change the junk food that they're eating.
Yeah,
too much junk food means you smell like trash or junk.
Mm-hmm. I like it, junky. I'm gonna make a children's book and it's gonna have like trash falling off of a bunny.
Yeah, let's do that. You do it.
And then with the sweet smells, I'm gonna have like candy scents coming.
Oh,
I just gotta figure out the words. I got the pictures in my head.
You're good with the words. I'm sure you'll figure that part out. Okay, well, that was our elephant in the room, and that was not as difficult to discuss as a lot of our other elephants.
But it is pretty uncomfortable.
It's real. It's real. Mm-hmm. And, you know, you don't want your kid to be that junior in high school where the teacher has to address it. Like, I just imagine my own daughter. I would be like, oh, my God.
You know, they're embarrassing me. Like, I hadn't taught you how to put on the
grown. Other. And the teacher had to tell you, I noticed must.
It happens in middle school a lot.
I can imagine middle school. Like, okay, you're learning all the hygiene. You got the hormones. pH balance is going to be off anyway. But, like, by the time you're high school, you're almost a woman. People be having babies at that age.
Mm-hmm. True.
Mm-mm-mm.
Keep yourself clean.
Please. And I know people have the day on them. That's what me and Alicia say. You smell like you got the day on you. Which means you...
I get it, but you're not... That doesn't necessarily mean must.
It's not must. It's like body. Like, you know you have not... You're not fresh.
Yeah.
Like, that's different than just being straight up
stanking
early in the morning.
Just straight up stanking.
You got a little bit of something, and that's fine. Like, okay.
You can rock and roll with an aroma.
I can't stand
it. Unpleasant.
Why is that
aroma.
So funny to me?
Because it's just funny
the way
to
you
think
said
about
it.
People oh, and aromas. You don't have to do all that when you mess you that y'all hit you in the face. That y'all come to you.
Girl, I remember one time.
Oh, Lord.
The professor was so musty, girl, and he had his. Because he liked their height. When the music comes on in the car, he had his hands up in the air. He was just, I said, zip your coat up.
Keep your arms
Keep the arms
close.
Down. I don't want it. I don't want any part of what you're
Not
doing.
Not even a little bit.
Zip it all away. It was one of those stupid puff coats. I said,
Don't push the air out of it. And that bitch just sit still. Now let that whole bubble coat fill up.
Trap it in.
Let it fill up.
I said, we're not doing hype man. We're not doing hype man today. You just need to turn down. Not for what? Because you're musty. You need to turn down. We're not partying. We're not waving our hands.
Why real stinking must just make you angry? Be your tail still somewhere. You just get angry and
we're not doing this today.
Your face.
It's just,
like my face.
Mine too.
It's just so tense right now. Just because that scent wasn't hits you, it's a wrap, man.
It's pungent.
Mm-hmm. Pungent aroma.
Let's segue into where, what, when. You talked about throwing out the shirt. That's musty.
I did throw that shirt
I
out.
I wonder
and
if.
And then he found it. I mean, I didn't throw it away.
And lost and found?
He put it back on the next week. And I said, Didn't I tell you don't wear that shirt?
It's microfibers. Is that what it is?
Yeah.
Oh, that is the one. Okay, so we are
so
still...
if you have any musty shirts, wear what when. If you have any shirts that have a yellow armpit, I feel like
we talked about
that.
The yellow
That's
on the white
review.
Shirt.
That's a review.
Yes.
Get rid of it. And if it has encapsulated a scent, get rid of it.
More of that. More of those words.
Get rid of
it. Why is this glass shaking so hard? It
because it's cold. Your hands shiver.
So, I have had multiple conversations about a list. You know what I'm talking about?
Yep.
People want us to make a list of essential clothes that you should have. It hit me from the back of my head because I wasn't thinking about that. We're thinking about where, what, when.
Yeah.
But just in these last 2 weeks, it's been do y'all have a list of the things that we should own? And I think it comes from if I'm making a suggestion to someone, we had a client and I said a button up white shirt. And I didn't realize that everybody does not own one of those. Apparently, there is a list that we need to make of things that just basic wardrobe items.
But remember, we even talked about the other week how my principal was like, I'm still waiting to get a white button-down shirt. And you were like, is she kidding?
Right.
And I'm like, no, for real, she said she doesn't have one.
Right. And then I got a little feedback from why, because I said, why don't you have one? What's the question? And she was like, either it fits weird, the material is stiff.
Fit is a big deal.
And she said, if I'm not wearing it under a suit jacket, it just is random. And I was like, okay, so we probably need to do something about the button-up white shirt, a reason why we feel like everybody should have one. Because I do strongly feel like everyone should.
And it's a variety of types that you can have, though, because
right.
I have a wide collar white shirt. I have a nicely